Okay, so from section 3.5 molecular mass and mole concept, this part is very important, basically the molecular mass, because when we will have to know about the compound its mole, then we have to know about its molecular mass, because molecular mass is closely related to the next term, that is mole concept. Okay, so to know about the molecular mass, we have to know about the atomic mass. Okay, so there is a difference, that is the atomic mass, which is regard to the comparison of 1/12 of a carbon 12 isomer, it is the how many multiple of that value, it is the atomic mass. In the same way, when we will assemble the atomic mass according to the with its number, that is the, if suppose AX, BY, CZ, okay, and this is the atomicity, A number, A atom is the X number, B atom in the Y number, and C atom in the Z number. Now, the atomic mass, that is A, the atomic mass of A is A, atomic mass of B is small b, and atomic mass of C is small c, and then X, Y, Z, these are the numbers of that atom. So, the molecular mass equal to AX plus BY plus CZ. If there is more atoms, then there should be more these values, these numerics. Okay. Now, come to one example regarding to that. So, C12, I am taking the glucose. Glucose having the formula C6H12O6. Now, here X means 6, here Y means 12, and here Z means 6. Now, we have to know about the atomic mass. So, atomic mass of carbon, atomic mass of carbon equal to 12, atomic mass of hydrogen equal to 1, and atomic mass of oxygen, that is equal to 16. Okay. Now, just put it in that formula, we can calculate the atomic mass of the molecular mass of that glucose molecule. Now, I am rubbing this part. So, AX, that is 12 into 6 plus BY, 1 into 12 plus C, that is 16 into Z, that is 6. So, 72 plus 12 plus 96, that is equal to 6, 8, 10, 1, 10, 11, 180. So, 180 is the molecular mass of glucose. So, glucose having the formula C6H12O6, just compare with the general formula, that is AXBYCZ. Here A, B, C are the carbon, hydrogen and oxygen, X that is 6, Y that is 12, and Z that is 6. Now, putting the atomic number, which is already known to us, the atomic mass of the constituents of the elements, then we can calculate the molecular mass of that. Okay. Now, next point is that, what is, now you can see the definition of the molecular mass. That the next unit is there, 3.5.2, that is formula unit mass. Now, formula unit mass is applicable for that molecule, that which does not contains any hard bond. Okay, there is no suitable bond length. For example, in the ionic solids or other ionic crystals or the ionic compounds, here only the electrostatic interaction is there, but there is no static bond length. So, when there is no static bond length for basically the ionic compound, then we will call for that type of molecule the formula unit mass. Here molecular mass is the formula mass is more appropriate for that type of compound, that is the ionic compounds. Okay. Now, What is the mole concept? Mole. Now, in today's chemistry, the very important term is mole. Now, mole is closely related to the molecular mass. Molecular mass. And with that, we have to know about one extra numeric value, which is Avogadro's number. Avogadro's number. What is this? So, Avogadro's number is having a numeric value which is 6.023 into 10 to the power 23. It is fixed, that is the Avogadro number of any type, that is the any elements, any compounds, any particle of substances are when they are reached to that level, that quantity, that is 6.023 into 10 to the power 23, then it will also call as 1 mole. And the molecular mass, what would be the molecular mass of that compound? It is also called as 1 mole. So, the molecular mass, when it is expressed in gram, then the mass of that compound is called 1 mole. Now, you can see the definition given here in your NCERT textbook, which will resembles that type of definition, that is when we will express the molecular mass in gram, then the overall molecular mass will be called as 1 mole. And the further definition of that is the weight or the mass of Avogadro number of particles or the compounds or the molecules is called as 1 mole. So, there are two definitions regarding to the mole. So, Avogadro number particles or molecules or atoms weight equal to 1 mole. This is the applicable for every particle, any compounds, atoms and molecules. Okay. So, this is the mole concept, and you can see that there is a reactions given 2H2 plus O2 equal to 2H2O. Now, here just from that, so when we will write H2, when we will write H2, then it representing here is a numeric, that is 1, and H2 is the molecule. Okay, so here it is 1 mole. When 2H2 is there, so this is the molecule. So, the numeric value before its molecule is 2. So, it is 2 mole. Okay. In the same way, oxygen. So, 3O2. Now, answer me, how many moles of oxygen is there? How many moles of oxygen is here? How many moles of oxygen? Yes, 3 mole. Rajanna gave the correct answer. Kinjal, it is 3 moles because the numeric value before the formula is 3. So, it is 3 moles of oxygen. Okay, when we will write oxygen, then it will represent the molecule. But when we will write atom, then it will represent the atom. Okay, so, just take one generalization. One general form, that is which is given in your book also, 2H2 plus O2, 2H2O. Now, 2 moles of hydrogen and 1 moles of oxygen reacts to produce 2 moles of water. Any problem? You cannot see the board properly. Okay, let me check any kind of problem is there. No, from here overall the board is visible, totally visible. the board is totally visible. Just check your network, or you may disconnect once and then also join again. Okay, so this is the general form, that is 2 moles of hydrogen reacts with 1 mole of oxygen to produce 2 moles of water. Okay, so now you can tell me, that I am writing down one more reaction, that is N2 plus 3H2 forming 2NH3. Now here, how many moles of nitrogen is there? How many moles of nitrogen is here? Yes, 1. How many moles of hydrogen is there? No, Ronit, it is not 2 mole. Here the atomicity is 2. Here the atomicity is 2, but it is not the molecule. Molecular mass, that is, if there is any numeric value, then it will be 1. Here 3 moles, and the ammonia produced, how many moles of ammonia produced? 2 moles, yes, correct. So we can make a general form of that, that 1 mole of nitrogen plus 3 mole of hydrogen produces 2 moles of ammonia, correct. Now we may further tell it as if they are gases. If they are gases, then this is one volume. This is one volume of nitrogen plus 3 volume of hydrogen produces 2 volume of ammonia, as when they are represented by in the gaseous form, because for gas it is the volume is to be measured. Okay, so this is the general form. If we further take the atomic mass unit, then we can also write the in the previous equation that how many U or AMU is there. Here 2 into 1 U, that is 2, that is 4 U. Oxygen 1, that is 2 into 16, that is 32 U. Now here 2 into 2 plus 16, that is 18, that is 36. Now add the total atomic mass unit of the reactant side and total atomic mass unit of the product side, then you can see that the mass of the reactant side is equal to the mass of the product side. So this ultimately tells that mass cannot be destroyed. Mass cannot be destroyed. This is the proof by that equation. Okay. So this is 4U, this is 32U, so 36U, here also 36U. Here mass is preserved in the reactant side and also in the product side. Now take a look on that. Just open your page number 40. In the lower half you can see a chart is given, 1 mole of carbon atom. Just see that in the left column it is given 6.022 × 10³ atoms of carbon. Now this number is the Avogadro's number, I tell you just in the definition about that, and in the right side 12 gram of carbon atom. Okay. So these three statements can be written in a straight line, that is 6.023 × 10³ number of carbon atoms, 6.022 × 10³ number of carbon atoms equal to 1 mole of carbon atom equal to 12 gram of carbon. Okay, so these three are the meaning of that three sentence are same. 6.023 number of carbon atom equal to 1 mole of carbon atom equal to 12 gram of carbon atom. Now, from that I will write one sentence that 6.023 into 10 to the power 23 number of carbon atom equal to 12 gram of carbon. As these three are in a relationship, so just take these two form, that is 6.023 number of carbon atom equal to 12 gram of carbon. Okay, so reversely we can write 12 gram of carbon atom contains 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 number of carbon atoms. So, from there 1 gram of carbon equal to contains 1 gram of carbon atom it contains 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 divided by 12 number of carbon atoms. Okay, so this equation will help you to calculate the mathematics, because regarding the mole concept, the atom, the gram atom, the molecular mass, these are all can be related by the Avogadro's number. Okay, so this then come to the next one, 1 mole of hydrogen atom. Now, what is the molar mass of hydrogen? What is the molar mass of hydrogen? Molar mass of hydrogen, molar mass, not atomic mass. Molar mass, that is H2, atomic mass, that is only hydrogen. So, here 2, yes. So, the molar mass of hydrogen equal to 2 and the atomic mass of hydrogen equal to 1. Now, come to the next point, that is 1 mole of hydrogen atom. So, here atom is mentioned. So, here the mass will be 1, but if there is the molecule will be mentioned, then it would be 2 gram. Now, in the left column, the same number of atoms is there, that is Avogadro number of atom is there, 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 and 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 number of hydrogen atom equal to 1 mole of hydrogen atom, that is equal to 1 gram of hydrogen. So, again we can relate it, that is 1 gram of hydrogen contains Avogadro number of hydrogen atoms. Come to the next one, 1 mole of any particle. Okay, so there is the generalization is given, that is atoms, molecules and ions. Okay, all the definitions are known to us, atoms, molecules, ions. And 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 number of that particle, it may be ion, it may be atom, or it may be molecule. And in the right side, relative mass of these particle in gram. Now, relative mass, that is the atomic mass, as it is the compared to the carbon scale or hydrogen scale, so it will be called as the relative mass. Okay, and the last line, that is 1 mole of molecules, that is 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 number of molecules. Okay, so when it would be for atom, then here we will mention the number of atoms. If it is the molecule, then it will be mentioned as number of molecules. Okay, so this is the mole concept and this is having the vast concept. Now come to the example, page number 41. Calculate the number of moles for the following: 52 gram of helium. 52 gram of helium. Can you tell me that how many moles of helium? 52 gram of helium. So helium is an inert gas. Here the atomic mass or molecular mass, but here the molecular mass, just calculate the number of moles for that. So here the molar mass will be taken into consideration, that is the 4, the molar mass of helium is 4, because the atomic mass and molecular mass is same for that inert gas, because the atomic state and the molecular state is same. So 52 gram, so the number of moles of helium equal to given mass divided by molecular mass. Okay, so given mass, that is 52 gram, and the molecular mass equal to 4 gram, so 13 moles. Come to the next one. 12.044 into 10 to the power 23 number of helium atoms. Okay, so we know that 6.022 into 10 to the power 23 equal to 1 mole. So 12 into 044 into 10 to the power 23, this is a very easier one. It is just double of that, so it would be 2 moles of helium. Okay, clear? Clear everyone? Okay, so now you can solve the questions from page number 40. Everyone will try that. In the page number 40, question number 1 and 2, calculate the molar mass of hydrogen, oxygen, chlorine, carbon dioxide, CH4, C2H6, NH3, CH3OH. And next is calculate the formula unit mass of zinc oxide, sodium oxide, potassium carbonate, and the atomic mass is given. Okay, so you can do it and you will complete these questions in your exercise book. Okay, any more problem? So the molecular mass and the mole concept is completed today, and some questions will be discussed later on the next class. Obviously, attendance will be taken. Have you any confusion regarding to that?